If you forgot your Amazon password or it doesn't work for some reason and you can't sign in, then keep watching and I'll show you how to reset your Amazon password. Let's unbox that. Hello, Rashid here from Proceed to Checkout, where we do tips and tutorials for Amazon customers like you. So if you have any questions or need help with your Amazon account, then start by subscribing or post any questions you have in the comments below. Okay, now for those of you who do know what your password is, but you want to change your password to a new one anyway, for whatever reason, you don't really need to reset the password like I'm about to show you. A better way is to change the password from inside your account after you signed in. So if you want to know how to do that, then check out the video, How to Change Your Password. I'll leave a link in the description and on the screen right now. If it's not up yet, then just ask your questions in the comments below. But for those of you who don't know your password and you can't sign in and you get this message saying your password is incorrect, you'll need to reset your password from the password assistance page on Amazon. I'll put a link to that in the description below, but if you want to go there yourself, then hover your cursor over Hello Sign In at the top. You'll get this drop down menu and then click on the yellow sign in button. That takes you to the sign-in page. You can ignore the email address for now and just click on Need Help. And then you'll see two options, and the one you want to click is Forgot Your Password. And that takes you to the password assistance page. Now, how this works is Amazon is going to send you a verification code to the email address or phone number that's associated with your Amazon account. In other words, not just to any email address or any phone number, just to the one that you use when you sign in to Amazon. So on this page, type in that email address or phone number. And by the way, if you don't have access to the email address on your account, maybe it's an old address or maybe it's a previous work or college email address, whatever the reason, if you don't have access to the email address anymore, you won't be able to reset the password yourself. But check out another video where I'll show you what to do in that situation. I'll put a link to that in the description as well. Anyway, once you've typed in your email address or phone number, click on Continue. And then you'll notice there's actually two ways of getting into your account. The first way, which is the one I'm showing you right now, is to reset your password to a new one. The second way is to use a temporary code to sign in just this one time. For most people though, it's better to reset the password, so select Set a New Password and then click Continue. And now you'll get this verify it's you message, which says that they've sent a verification code to the email address that's on your account. Let me just quickly explain that. Amazon will only allow you to change the password if you are the person who owns this account. And that's why they send an email only to the email address that's on this account, because presumably only the owner of the account has access to that email. So leave this page open and go to your email. The subject line will be Amazon Password Assistance. And when you open that mail, you'll find a 6-digit code. So copy that code and then you can go back to Amazon and type in or paste that code here and then click Continue. And now that you've proven that you are the owner, you can reset the password on this page. You'll see some password tips at the bottom, but let me give you a few more. You can use as little as 6 characters for your password, but it's better and safer if it's at least 8 characters long. You can use all letters or all numbers or a combination of both. You can use characters like exclamation mark, dollar sign, ampersand, and so on. Just remember that the password is case sensitive. If you set your password as Kofefe with an uppercase O, then you'll need to enter exactly the same password with a capital O every time you sign in from now on. I know it sounds obvious, but before becoming a team leader, I worked in Amazon's password assistance team, and lots of people reset the password but then struggle to sign in afterwards, and in many cases it's because of this case sensitivity. If I try to sign in tomorrow using Kofefe with a lowercase O, then it won't work because that's incorrect. That's not the password that I've saved. So pay close attention to exactly what you're saving here as your password. Okay, so type in what you want the password to be where it says new password. Then type in again exactly the same password where it says re-enter password. If you don't type it in exactly the same, then you'll get an error message that says the passwords must match. And once you've done that, click on Save Changes. That will save the new password and you'll be signed into your account automatically. You'll know that because instead of saying hello sign in, it will now say hello and your name. If you get something like this asking if you'd like to save the password, that's not from Amazon. That's a message from your browser. I'm using Safari. Basically, the browser is asking if you'd like it to remember this new password for you. If you say yes, then the next time you sign in, your browser will fill in the password. It will auto-populate the password and you don't have to type it in yourself. So you can say yes if you like, but obviously don't do that if you're not using your own computer. Just the last word of caution about that. If you reset your password like I just showed you, and you don't tell your browser to save the new password, and then the first time you sign in after that, you see that your browser fills in the password, that's not the new password. That's an old password that your browser had saved previously. If you just click sign in, it's not going to work. So take out that autofill password and manually type in the new one yourself, and that should work. If you have any questions about this video or anything else related to your Amazon account, leave them in the comments below. I really do try to answer all of them. And if you like this video, give it a like. If you want to see more Amazon tips and tutorials, then hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you again in the next one.